Good morning, dear students. Welcome back again with the new session of Science 1, Lesson number 13, Carbon, an Important Element. First of all, we'll discuss about something about the element, carbon element. Now, in order to understand the concept of carbon element, here some demonstration is being done. Take some milk in an evaporating dish. Heat the evaporating dish on a Bunsen burner. What happens behind at the bottom of an evaporating dish or complete evaporation of the milk? Another demonstration. Take some small samples of sugar, wool, dry leaves, hair, seeds, split pulses, plastic in a separate test tube. Heat each test tube and observe the changes taking place in the substances. What does the black substance remaining in each of the tube indicates? The black substance is nothing but the carbon. Carbon. The element carbon is available abundantly in the nature and occurs in the free as well as in the combined state. In this chapter, let us study the properties of the non-metallic element carbon. Now, before we start, certain other peculiarities of the features of the carbon. Symbol of carbon is capital C. Atomic number 6. Atomic mass number 12. Electronic configuration 2,4. Valency 4. It is a non-metallic element. Make a list of all substances that you use in your daily life from morning till night and divide those substances into the columns in the following table. After preparing this, you'll observe that the objects which we are using in our day-to-day life, in each and every object, approximately little amount of carbon is always there. Near about each and every content. Now look at the list of the objects in the last column. It contains foodstuff, clothes, medicine, fuels, wooden objects, etc. Carbon is the common and the most important constituent of all these substances. Compound obtained directly or indirectly from plants and animals are called as organic compounds, and compounds obtained from minerals are called as inorganic compounds. This is a definition of organic and inorganic. So whatever objects you obtain from the plants and animals, they are called as organic, and if you obtain it from the minerals, it is called as inorganic. All the organic compound contains carbon. Carbon is the main element even in a cellular DNA and RNA that transfer characteristics from the one generation to the next. Now, occurrence of carbon. The name carbon is derived from the Latin word carbo, means coal. Coal is found in nature as well as nature in free as well as in the compound state. Carbon in the free state is found in diamond and graphite, and in the combined state, it is the following compounds. As carbon dioxide in the form of carbonates, such as calcium carbonate, marble, calamine, that is ZnCO3, fossil fuel, coal, petroleum, natural gas, carbonaceous nutrients, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, natural fibers, cotton, wool, silk. In the earth crust, carbon is present in the extent of approximately 0.27% in the form of carbonate, coal, petroleum in the atmosphere. The proportion of carbon in the form of carbon dioxide is approximately 0.03%. Some types of plants which grow in the ocean floor convert carbon in marine water into calcium carbonate. The properties of carbon is there, that is allotropic form, that we'll discuss it in the next video. Till then, have a great day.